know who I am. I'm walking in power. I'm walking in miracle. I need a life of heaven. Cause I know who I am. Let's go for the shadow. Oh, 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 oh. I know who I am.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
Do you know who you are?
I know my
Hallelujah. If you know who you are, you will walk in power. You will walk in dominion. Hallelujah. Please let us be on our feet. For you are glorious and worthy to be praised.
You are the Lamb
upon the throne. And unto you I lift my voice to say, you are the Lamb upon the throne. Jesus, you are the Lamb upon the throne. Jehovah, you are the Lamb upon the throne. Jesus, you are the Lamb upon the throne. The blood of Jesus set me free from sins and sorrows.
The blood of Jesus set me free.
The blood of Jesus.
The blood of Jesus set me free
from sins and sorrows. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus.
The blood of Jesus set me free
from sins and sorrows.
The blood of Jesus set me free.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
I want us to lift up our voice in appreciation and say, Lord, we thank you for this very hour that we are here now. We glorify your name because you are the God who made it possible. You are the God Almighty who gave us life. Lord, it is by strength that we are alive today. It is not of our power. It is not of our strength. Father, we say thank you. Somebody lift up your voice. Worship him.
King of glory.
Give him the glory. Hallow his name. Hallow his name.
Thank you, O Lord, for the privilege.
He is worthy.
O Lord, to be among the living. O Lord.
You alone are not worthy, Lord.
There is none like you, O Lord. Take all the glory.
To be praised and adored. You alone are not worthy, Jehovah. To be praised and adored. You be faithful, God. You be faithful, God. From the hedges past, Bahitali Kosa, Bahitali Kosa, Bayada, Itali Bosa, Itali Kosa, Bayada. Hey, you alone are not worthy, my Father, to be praised and adored, Bahosa, Talada, Bayada. You alone are not worthy, Abba Father, to be praised and adored. You be faithful, God.
You be faithful, God.
Let us sacrifice. 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 We bless your holy name. Somebody need to worship him. Bless his name, Lord. We worship you. Be the glorified. Baradosa.
Frustrating my effort.
That has been frustrating.
As I pray now, cast fire. Open your mouth and pray. Jam those hands and pray. Every power frustrating my effort. Denying me my blessing. Denying me my glory. I say cast fire. In the name of Jesus. New power frustrating my power. Frustrating my glory. Frustrating my joy. Frustrating my happiness. What are you waiting for? Cast fire. Cast fire. That's fire! That's fire! That's fire!
I command you right now.
Thank you, Father.
I command you
in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
In Acts 27 verses 3 and 4, the Bible says, and Paul determined to enter Italy, but there was a contrary wind denying him of entering into Italy. I don't know that contrary wind in your life that have denied you happiness, that have denied you document, that have denied you joy. By the power of the Holy Ghost, they shall crumble today.
Amen.
I said they shall crumble today.
Amen.
Say, my Father, my Father,
my father.
Every contrary wind in my life that is denying me my blessing, as I pray now, fire! Open your mouth and pray.
In the name of Jesus.
Baradadada. Yekadada balada balada. My Father. My Father. Every contrary wind pushing us to wrong destination. Pushing us to wrong destination. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of
Jesus. Let us fire. 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 Let us fire.
We come in the name of Jesus.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
In the name of Jesus.
Say, all you powers,
all you powers
that is monitoring my glory,
that is monitoring my
sources, in the name of Jesus, God's fire. Open your mouth and pray. Every monitoring power, every monitoring spirit, every evil mirror, monitoring my glory, monitoring my destiny. What are you waiting for? That's fire. That's fire. That's fire. That's fire. That's fire. That's fire.
My glory.
Holy Ghost. 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 Let it transpire. Every monitoring spirit. Every formula. Holy God in my glory. That's fire. That's fire. That's fire. That's fire. That's fire.
Fire.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Listen to me. We're going to pray one more time. Listen. You may look these people as foolish. That somebody go woke up in the morning and blow a powder in the hair, and you think that powder does not have power. Until you pray, you are a prey.
Oh yes.
If you don't pray, you are a victim.
Uh-huh.
We are going to pray. The Bible says in Numbers 23 that no enchantment against Jacob, no divination against Israel. The Bible says in Isaiah 7:7, for thus says the Lord, he shall not stand, neither shall he come to pass. Say, my father, my father,
my father, my father,
every evil weapon,
every evil weapon
that have been designed,
has been designed
to bring me down, according to your word,
according to your word,
it shall not stand, neither shall it come to pass. Somebody pray, it shall not stand, it shall not stand, it shall not stand. We frustrate your power, we frustrate your power,
we frustrate the heaven, according to your word.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
The Bible says, this is the last prayer. The Bible says in Numbers 14:28, he said, whatever you says to my ear, that will I do. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In John 14:14, Jesus said, ask anything in my name and I will do it. Amen.
Amen.
I don't know if your life has been so good before, leave it, don't pray. But if nothing has been working out, take this opportunity and say, Lord, as I came here this morning, let there be a divine turnaround.
Amen.
Say, my father, my father.
My father, my father.
Because of my presence here this morning.
Because of my presence here this morning.
Let there be a divine turnaround.
Let there be a divine turnaround.
I am tired of being in the same position.
I
am tired of singing the same song.
I
need a testimony.
I need a
miracle.
I need a miracle.
Open your mouth and pray.
Prophesy. As I have presence today,
oh
my life will never
remain.
I need a testimony.
I need a miracle. Please, let there be silence, please. Let those hands be lifted up. You can play slowly. And so, Father, we thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
We thank you because there is no God like you.
At all.
We thank you because none can deliver like you do.
Oh, yes, Lord.
None can save like you do.
At all, Baba.
None can heal like you do.
At all, Lord.
All other gods are the works of man's hand.
Oh, yes, Lord.
But thou, oh God, are true and righteous,
oh,
God.
Yes,
from
Lord.
Time immemorial to time infinite.
Thank you, Father.
For there is no comparing of thee.
At all, Lord.
You are the rock of our salvation.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Our hiding place.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Our shed.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Our buckler.
Thank you, Jesus.
Our redeemer.
Thank you, Jesus.
Our hope.
Thank you, Jesus.
Our chain breaker, our way maker, our freedom giver, our Red Sea divider, the ocean divider. We thank you, Lord, for there is no one like you. You are Alpha, you are Omega, you are the beginning, you are the end, you are the first, you are the last. Father, we bless your name.
Thank you, Jesus.
Father, right from this altar to the entrance, let only you be seen here.
Amen.
Let only your voice be heard.
Amen.
Let only your move proceed.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We increase the intensity of fire here, Lord.
Amen.
We decree this place a fire zone.
Amen.
Do us for any powers to operate.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We cover everyone here with the blood of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus.
We arrest every contrary powers.
Amen.
Every contrary spirit.
Amen.
That want to assert themselves against your knowledge.
Amen.
We bring them to captivity now.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Fathers, we came here, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
As our faces are different,
yes, Baba.
So our heart desires are different.
Yes, Baba.
Meet us at the point of our need.
Amen.
May we not go home the way we came here
Amen.
Today.
Amen.
May we go home celebrating.
Amen.
May we go home rejoicing.
Amen.
May we go home fulfilled.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, whatever has beginning has an end.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Today, I decree the end of problems in our
lives.
I decree the end of sicknesses in our
lives.
I decree the end of tribulations.
Amen.
I decree the end of the wicked one.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Today, mark the end of every powers of the enemies.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
From today, we become a new man.
Amen.
For in Jesus, mighty holy name we pray.
Amen. Amen.
Sit down on your enemy's head without apology. Sit down, break it. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus.
God bless you.
Hallelujah. How many of you are happy to be here this morning?
Come on, if you're happy.
If you're happy, let me see your hands. Jam those hands to Jesus. Janet, if you're happy. We do it like gentlemen, which I like. But radicality in the spirit realm profit more. Hallelujah. I often say, if you are too gentle, you end up in the kento. So I don't want to end up in kento. Hallelujah. I don't want to end up in fire. I said, if you are happy, jam those hands to Jesus. If in your clapping is in your testimony, somebody will be clapping more. Somebody will be jubilating.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hey. Amen. Victory belongs to you. As you have celebrated the Lord, may the Lord cause heaven to celebrate you. In Jesus' name we pray. I'm not going to take much time this morning. Hallelujah. By the special grace of God, I'm dealing with the message which I titled, Saved by Grace. Hallelujah. Saved by grace. Amen. Let's take our Bible quickly. Psalms chapter number 8, verse 6, 4 and 5. Psalm number 8 and verses number 4 and 5. Please, you can do me good while we are here. Now you can put off your phones, your tablet, please.
Jesus' name.
Amen.
What is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou visitest him? For thou hast made him a little lower than the angels, and hast crowned him with glory and honor.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Saved by grace. David said here, what is man that thou art mindful of him? And the son of man that thou visited him, for thou hast made him a little lower than the angels, and hast crowned him with glory and honor. Who am I that thou carest about me? Of all the created things, but thou choose to honor me. Hallelujah. It is not because you are good. It is not because you are rich. It is not because you are intelligent. It is because grace has found you. Somebody say, grace has found me. Say, grace has found me. The life of grace is not the life of labor. When grace is upon your life, heaven honors every of your actions. Heaven honors every step you take. Heaven honors everything you do.
Amen.
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 David began to look around when he saw where he came from. He saw the bigger brothers. He saw the mighty one, the most awesome one. And he began to ask God, what have I done that I desire these good things? Of all my family, you decided to bring me out of nowhere and make me somebody. I don't know whom I'm talking to this morning. God is bringing you out of nowhere. God is taking you to somewhere.
Amen.
Those who have relegated you before,
yes,
may heaven cause them to honor you.
Amen.
I said, may heaven cause them to honor you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
David said, what have I done?
Uh-huh.
Who am I? What is that exactly thing that I've done that has caused you to find favor in me? That has caused you to prompt your attention on me. In everything I do, you are glorified.
Oh, yes.
What have I done? Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Just as this young man, Brother Austin and Sister Blessing, will ask, what have I done that I merit a baby? There are people who are going around doing different things to have baby.
Right,
but heaven decided to honor you. If you were to pay for this baby, can you afford it?
At all, sir.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
God decided to butter your bread. He decided to beautify your life. Why? There is something he sees in you.
Oh, yes.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
David said, of all my family, I am the least.
Mm-hmm.
Why did you choose me? I am not like my eldest brothers who have broad shoulders, who are handsome. I am not like every other one. I am not even one of them that stays at home. I am the most least, the most dirtiest, and the regardless one in the bush. But you decided to pick me from the bush and place me in the palace.
Thank you, Jesus.
What did you see in me, Lord?
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Look at where you are now.
Uh-huh.
You are not here because you decided to be here.
That's all.
You are here because God took you by his own hand.
Amen.
And said, my son, follow me. I will show you the goodness of this life. As long as you are faithful to me, I will cause you to enjoy the blessings.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
That is why you are here. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Saved by grace. There are many who started a journey with you. Many who came through the sea, who came through the desert. Some lost their lives on the way.
Yes, sir.
But grace found you.
Hallelujah.
Grace found you.
Hallelujah.
Not because you paid for this.
At all.
But because God decided to smile on you.
Jesus.
He decided to bring your matter before the heavenlies and said, this shall be our assignment. We are not going to relent until this one become one of us.
Amen.
We are not going to be tired until this one enjoy like us.
Amen.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You are who you are today because grace found you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
May that same grace of God upon your life not go down.
Amen.
I said, may the grace of God speak on you not go down.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
When David began to realize, of all, I am a sinner. What have I done that you love me so much? Jesus, you love me too much. Oh. Too much, oh,
too much, oh, excess love.
Come on, take it, take it. Jesus,
you love me too much, oh,
daddy.
Too much, oh, too much, oh, excess love.
Your love
is kind. Your love is
patient, Lord, you fill my heart, oh,
you fill
my heart with so much peace and joy,
so much peace
and joy.
And your
amazing,
you make my life feel
brand new.
You are amazing. Jesus, you love me too much, oh.
Too much, excess love, oh. Jesus, you love me too much, oh.
Too much, excess love, oh.
Excess love, oh. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Please be seated. Thank you. It is the love of God that brought you alive this morning. There are many who went to bed last night. Hallelujah. They have plans as you have. They had visions. They had purpose only to go to bed last night, but to wake up there no more. But grace found you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Grace found you.
Yes.
Where you were not qualified, grace found you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise
Please
the Lord.
Please lower the noise over there. Grace found you. It is because God decided to smile on you.
Oh, yes.
When David asked the question, who am I? I began to look at myself. Father, what is it that I have done that you decided to use me? What is it that I have done that you decided to bless me? What is it that I have done that you decided to show yourself in my life? Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Look at your life now. It is the grace of God. That is why you are alive.
Oh, yes.
No wonder Apostle Paul says in 1 Corinthians 15. Can we read? 1 Corinthians 15 verse 10. I am who I am. I am what I am.
1 Corinthians chapter 15 verses 10. I read in Jesus' name.
Amen.
But by the grace of God, I am what I am.
Hallelujah. It is by the grace of God we are who we are today.
Oh, yes.
We are because He is.
Oh, yes.
We are alive because He is alive.
Oh, yes.
We are smiling because He is rejoicing over there.
Yes.
So it is His grace that has caused us to be alive.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
It is not of our power
at all.
The Bible says the race is not of him that willeth,
at all.
Not of him that runneth.
At all.
It is of the Lord who shows mercy.
Hallelujah.
It is of the Lord who decides to butter your bread.
Amen.
It is of the Lord who decides to give you smile.
Amen.
When all men are expecting you to fall,
oh, yes.
That is where God says, my son, walk with me, I am with you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We are saved by grace. Yes. It is not because we paid for it.
At all.
But because one paid for it on the cross.
Oh, yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
In those days in the Old Testament, it was all about judgments. You don't dare God and go free. You don't sin against God and still be alive. But now, the grace of our Lord Jesus is interceding for somebody.
Thank you,
the grace is meditating for somebody.
Thank you,
the grace is propitiating for somebody.
Thank you,
that is why we are still standing.
Oh, yes.
That is why we are still alive.
Oh, yes,
that is why we are still celebrating.
Oh, yes,
that is why we are still rejoicing.
Oh, yes,
give him hallelujah.
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 Praise the Lord.
Please be seated. Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Apostle Paul understanding the mystery of grace. He said, of all the apostles, I am the least. In other words, I did not walk with Jesus the way every other apostles walk with Jesus.
Yes.
I did not eat with him the way others ate with him.
Uh-huh.
I did not sat or sleep with him the way other disciples sat with him.
Uh-huh.
But his grace upon my life is mightier than those who walk with him. Hallelujah. So that's grace. When God decided to beautify your life with grace, it doesn't matter how long people have been competing with your life. Life no longer become turn by turn. Life become grace by turn.
Hallelujah.
You don't have to wait in the line to have what you have. God picks you from the last and make you the first.
Hallelujah.
That is the life of grace.
Amen.
The life of David is the life of grace.
Oh, yes.
The life of Joseph is the life of grace.
Oh, yes.
God picked them from nowhere and make them somebody.
Oh, yes.
I don't know who God is taking from this level to another level. I don't know who God is taking from this level zero to level of celebration, to the level of testimony. If you are the one, shout the loudest hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
the Lord.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You know, this grace, G-R-O-A-C-E, when we remove the G, G stands for God. Is it true?
Yes, sir.
When we remove the G, it becomes race. And therefore, it is impossible to complete the race without God. So when God is removed from the grace, it becomes race, and no man shall finish this race without God.
Hallelujah.
So that is why we need God in the race to have a grace to succeed.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Listen, where you are now, it may not be working out. You may not have it. I don't have. I cannot go to church. I just don't feel like. I don't have money to pay my tithe and offering. I will not go to church. Listen to me. God allowed it so.
Oh yes.
God is aware of that situation.
Oh yes.
God is aware that you have not money to pay, but He's trying your heart whether you can love Him with money or without money.
Hallelujah.
But people doesn't understand. They say, "I don't have money. I cannot go to God." When you don't have money, who do you go to? Our help is in God.
Oh yes.
Our help is not in man.
At all.
Even though you go and borrow money and come back, you are still going to be in debt. But when you come to God and say, "Baba, this is who I am. I have nothing." He gives you His best.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Jesus found me just as I am. Empty-handed, but alive in Your realm. Majesty.
Forever I am changed by Your love, in the presence of Your majesty, majesty.
Hallelujah. Forever we are changed by His love. It is His grace. That is where we are now. What then is grace? Grace, as we all know, is unmerited favor.
Oh yes.
The favor you did not work for, God decided to put you to enjoy it.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
David never worked as to compare every of his younger brother, every of his eldest brother.
At all.
But God picked him and made him the captain. Amen. And the king of Israel.
Amen.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
That is the life of grace.
Oh, yes.
Grace qualifies you for favor.
Amen.
When grace is upon your life, every of your efforts is honored by heaven.
Oh yes.
Everything you do, heaven support you.
Amen.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
There are people, I often say it here, there are people where we came from who are still struggling. You see truck pushers. Hallelujah.
Praise the
you
Lord.
You see truck pushers. You see how grab, how muscular they are. Is it
yes.
true? Come
yes,
on.
Sir.
Can you
sir.
Divide to it?
Oh yes.
A truck pusher will be pushing truck. By the time the truck falls into a pot, it will be dragging. You will see them, they'll become so grabbed, so strong. They are using power. It does not have to be power. Hallelujah. It does not have to be power.
At all.
It has to be God.
Yes.
By strength.
No man prevail.
1 Samuel 2 now. By strength shall no man prevail. It is not by your power.
At all.
It is not how thick you are.
At all.
It is how big God is.
Hallelujah.
When God is glorified in that situation,
oh, yes.
that situation becomes nothing.
Amen.
But when God is diminished, the problem is being magnified.
Mm.
And therefore you swallowed.
Mm.
Amen.
Amen.
In where you are now, are you seeing God as the number one?
Mm.
We may say with our mouths that we are, according to Isaiah 29, that these people draw close to me with their mouths. Their lips, their heart is far from me. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
If you are, then your life will be sweet.
Amen.
I said, if you are, your life will be sweet.
Amen.
Listen, where you are now, sorrow may endure for a night. Things may be rough. It may be so difficult now to pay your house rent. It may be so difficult now to pay your bills, not to even send money to feed people back there. But God said, follow me, I will make you the head.
Hallelujah.
You are the head, but yet there is nothing to show now. It does not mean God has lied.
At all.
God cannot lie.
At all.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
I say God cannot lie.
At all.
Where you are now cannot deny God of being God.
At all, at all.
If only you can be faithful with him. Amen.
Amen.
He leads you to a certain stage where he wants you to overcome some certain trials by yourself. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
He wants you to grow up to a maturity where you can say, Lord, I have decided to follow you.
Oh yes.
Not because what I want, but because of who you are.
Oh yes.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The life of grace cannot be admeasured.
At all.
When grace is upon your life, may seek you to favor you.
Amen.
May I say, oh, I know him. I know him.
Oh yes.
But look at people who are struggling today. They don't make efforts. Even if they make effort, they don't make profits. Even if they make profit, they don't make productivity. They are not productive. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
But a little you have, listen to me, I want to give you wisdom now. A little you have, because grace is upon your life. A man who started with one machine, 200 naira in New Benin market, is becoming a millionaire today. Why? Grace. Everything you do is grace.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Many of us, we want to live a very beautiful life, competitive life. We want to be like others. I often warn the members of this ministry, be careful. This is Europe. A day will come, you will go back home. Hallelujah.
Praise
it
the
doesn't
Lord.
Matter how old you are. Even at your 80, 90, you will still desire to go back to your house. Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
But one thing is, don't waste the grace. This is not a day of grace where we have strength to make it. You don't have to be a drug addict, a drug smuggler before you make it in life.
At all.
You don't have to be a scammer, 419, before you become somebody in life.
At all.
Wisdom is the principal thing.
Oh yes.
A man who walks 20 euro every day, at the end of the month, you are talking about 600 euro. If 600 euro, you are able to send 200 euro at home, you can buy Okada. Okada, in 3 years, you will not have one Okada, you will have two Okada. That is where life starts. But we prefer to use that 200 euro to buy you, to show to our friends that we are reigning Europe. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Don't waste that grace. Many of us can buy trousers, jeans of 80 euro. These are good. I'm not against it. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
But you should have something tangible before you start living exorbitantly. If maybe the breeze blow, where is your roots? Where will you fall to? Some will fall below ground. Nothing that will waste them on the hair. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Not even 6 blocks can hold you. Not even 7 blocks. Not even foundation. Not even anything to sell to start up again. Not even machine to grind or bolo. Then where is the grace? God said, I will make you somebody. He took you here and he left you in the midst of abundance. But some, even, I think there is a saying. He said, yes. Even a fool in the midst of ocean still taste of water. Is it truth?
Yes, sir.
God brought you here that you use your wisdom. Your 20 arrow every day can change your life in the next 6 months. But we desire to become like others. Now we dey reign. You want to reign with others when you never even start anything. You want to start. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise Jesus. I will preach the truth to you.
And I will tell you the gospel fact. Please, can somebody give me a better thing, please? I will preach the gospel fact to you. Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Life, not be how you think I'm.
At all.
Now, as you apply wisdom, that life they be for you.
Oh, yes.
Any man can dream of becoming big. Is it truth?
Yes, sir.
Ask every one of us here now. What is our plan? We want to become rich. Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Come on, answer me. What is our plan? We want to become big now.
To become great.
Is it truth?
Yes, sir.
But the truth is, thank you, man. You can give me. You can give it to me. God bless you, man.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
A man who sow a seed of corn today, tomorrow will not harvest a seed of corn.
At all.
He will enjoy abundance.
Oh, yes.
But if you are an hungry lion, an hungry man, you will eat that seed of corn today. You will be okay.
Uh-huh.
In the next 6 days, you will die of starvation. Yes. But if you plan and decided to remain starvation, for the next 6 days, the corn will begin to germinate and decide whether to give you abundance.
Yes.
What makes men fail is the abuse of grace.
Right on, sir.
Are you following me?
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir. What makes men fail? It is because you abuse grace. God took you from nowhere and brought you here. You are still making it. At least, listen, at the end of every month, what you make, bankers does not make it in Nigeria.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling you.
Yes, sir.
There are people who are living on 20,000, get men, living on 20,000, they have wives and children in Nigeria, and they still survive. That is what you get in a day. And yet abuse grace and said, I don't tire for Europe. I don't tire. You are telling God. Why are you sure you are God?
Ah, tell us, sir.
Hallelujah. Sir. Abuse of grace. Little that you have can make you become rich tomorrow.
Oh, yes.
But we decided to eat that one corn and say, another one will come tomorrow. If I go lunch and I go work 20 euros, I go put down for yesterday. You are getting old. Your time is past. Many of us, we started 10 years, 15 years, 10, 12 years ago. We're very agile. But those things, we can no longer do them again.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
When I newly came here, 12, 13 years ago, I was very smart. I can play football. Some of you can testify. I can play football very well. But now, I can't even jump. Time is going. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
If you don't do something now, don't blame God tomorrow in your old age.
At all, sir.
God gave you grace to succeed. Your foolishness desire to rob you of that grace.
Tell us, sir. You are right, sir.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
A man who earns 300 euro can do something with his life. You don't have to become big. My father told me one word. He said, Ogbala, Kerekere, Omasevela. Are you following me?
Yes, sir.
The tap is dripping. It's better than it's not even dropping at all. At least with patience, that bowl you put under there will full, no matter the time. Mm-hmm. At least there is something enter. You can take 10 arrow, send it there. It becomes something at the end of the year. You will not be a man of 200,000. What makes people fail is because tomorrow it go better, it go better. Mm-hmm. When now you eat them, you are abusing grace.
Tell us, sir.
I just want to be truthful with you. Amen.
Amen.
Otherwise, I would have just preached it beautiful and we go home. But the truth is, the application of the word is wisdom. If you apply the word you hear, it shows that you are wise, you are mature.
Yes.
What does the Bible say in Matthew 13? It said, when you hear the parable of the kingdom and you did not understand, the devil come to steal it. The reason I'm coming down so low is so that you will understand that when you fail, it does not depend on God. You fail yourself, you fail God, you fail your family, you fail your born children, you fail your generation, and you fail people who will hereafter depend on you.
Right on,
there are
sir.
Many of us who God have assigned people to our destiny.
Yes.
We are to feed them, we are to help them.
Yes,
by
sir.
The time we fail those generations.
Tell us, sir.
Hallelujah. So for this reason, don't I say, never attempt to fail. Why? There are nations, there are generations, there are people, when you look back, there are people who are waiting that in someday, I know you are going to make it.
Yes.
You will remember us. When you look back to those things, you just afford to fail.
Tell us, sir.
You don't have to wait for grace to carry you from where you are now to another place. The grace that took you from where you are to where you are now, you should appreciate it so that you'll be elevated.
Oh, yes. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
What is your problem? Ah, God. And I know nothing I say will be for Europe. I for not just come. My life better. God for brought Nigeria. You for a purpose.
Yes, sir.
If you were there better in Nigeria or in where you came from, you would not be alive now.
At all.
God decided to remove you for a reason.
Yes,
so
sir.
That when those trouble comes, at least it will not meet you. That is why you are here. Many of you, you are in the camp of preservation. Jam those hands for Jesus. Come to think of it this way. If you are still, if many of you were still in Nigeria, some of you would have been the cultist.
Uh-huh.
And by now, you would have been gunned down. By now, your life would have been nowhere. But God decided to take you. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Don't say, ah, I used to have it, I don't have it now. God knows why.
Yes.
God knows why.
Oh, yes.
When God told Joseph, I will make you the breadwinner of your house. Did God explain to him that he was going to go to prison?
No, sir.
Did God ever told him that somebody will lie against him?
No, sir.
So whatever you go through in life is part of God's plan.
Oh, yes.
We learn to commit all to him and say, Lord, this is your will.
Oh, yes.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
God never told him, listen, you are going to be in prison. You are going to be lied against. You are going to be frustrated by your friends. God never explained. God does not give details. He gives dreams.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
When God gives you a dream, you are the one to use your wisdom to find out what is your calling in that dream.
Amen.
Don't wait God to come and explain it.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Many of us, we are waiting God. Father, you don't give me meat. You don't give me food. Give me spoon. My hand dirty. Give me spoon. I need spoon. You are there wasting your time. I need spoon, Lord. That is the only thing holding me now. If not, I would have long been succeeding. No, cast spoon. Find spoon for yourself. When there is no work, stand up and go and find work. Don't wait for God to come and give you work while you are in your bed.
Tell us.
Go out and seek something to do,
oh,
and
yes.
you will succeed.
Amen.
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 Many of us, we define work, we define work. We carry our shorty. My way won't give you work. I go to give you work when you're not serious. You carry work and you define work. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Take 2 days in a week. Sacrifice those days if you really need it. Take it and say, oh, my friend, I want to leave this curriculum vitae with you. I want to leave this and see whether God will not answer. But for the fact that you already have goose in your hand, you have your bag, and you carry curriculum, somebody will ask you, are you serious? You are looking for work. You are already doing work. Amen.
Amen.
They will not take you serious. Life is all about sacrifice. Grace brought you this far. Don't abuse that grace to fail. When you fail, it does not depend on God. It depends on you.
Yes, sir.
You decided to fail.
Yes, sir. That is
failure is inexcusable, but you can overcome failure. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
This life is like a journey we all started. When the evening comes, we all will go back to our homes.
Yes.
Is it true?
Yes, sir.
Is it true?
Yes, sir.
When you go back home, you did not spread your bed. Where will you lie? That's a parable. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Please let us take our Bible quickly. 1 Timothy chapter 1, verses number 12. I promised us I was not going to take long time, but God be glorified.
1 Timothy chapter 1, verses 12, I read in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And I thank Christ Jesus, our Lord, who hath enabled me, for that he counted me faithful, putting me into the ministry, who was before a blasphemer and a persecutor and injurious, but I obtained mercy. Because I did it ignorantly
in all belief. Uh-huh.
And the grace of our Lord was exceeding abundant with faith and love, which is in Christ Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I thank the Lord Jesus. I thank Christ Jesus, our Lord, who has enabled me. In other words, I was not qualified. He decided to qualify me. I was not enabled. I was disabled. I was not good. He decided to enable me, repair me, and put me into his work. Verses 14 says something very interesting. And the grace of our Lord Jesus was exceedingly
abundant
with faith. Hallelujah. So grace qualified Apostle Paul. Even of all the apostles, I said before, he was not the one who saw Jesus face to face. He never ate. Even some who ate with him face to face betrayed him. Some who walked with him and said, Lord, I will do this, denied him. Some who said, I will be everything for you, wait, oh, they ran away. But here comes a man who never saw him. In fact, who was even killing him. But Jesus decided to say, no, there is something good in you that I want to make use of.
Hallelujah.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
God sees the hand from the beginning.
Oh, yes.
According to Isaiah 46, verse 11. He declares the hand from the beginning. He knows everything that is good in every man. And that is why he chooses you out of your family. And that is why you are here. I love to use this word every time. Many of you, 10, 15 years ago, you never decided, you never dreamt of being here. Is it true?
Yes, sir.
But in your destiny, it was written that on the 20th of February, 2021, you will be in a church at about 12:35. You will be listening to a man of God and you will be preaching. And now you are fulfilling destiny. Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
This was what was written before time.
Well, yes.
And many of us, we do not understand what is time. There is a message God gave to me. Understanding time and season of life. Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
If you don't understand, you can just believe in when daybreak, I go out, I come back. There is more to life than just going out and coming in.
Right on, sir.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I pray on Tuesday, God will give me wisdom to teach that message.
Amen.
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 He said, I thank the Lord Jesus. Who has enabled me and has counted me faithful? Who has enabled me and has what? Counted me faithful. Even though I was a sinner, I was persecuting the church. I was destroying his foundation he laid. But he still see goodness in me. He still saw faithfulness in me and decided to bring me in and said, no, you will become a useful material. Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Your life may be at a state of devastation now, but God is going to make use out of you.
Amen.
You may not see anything good out of your life now. Listen to me. God is the one that called light out of darkness.
Oh, yes.
It was not possible that darkness to produce light.
At all.
But because God is the good possibility specialist,
oh, yes.
He called forth light out of darkness.
Amen.
I want to ask a question. Can darkness produce light?
No, sir.
Can darkness produce light?
No, sir.
But because all things are possible with God,
oh, yes.
Darkness has to vomit light.
Amen.
That is why something good is coming out of you.
Amen.
I said that is why something good is coming out of
Amen.
You.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You may dedicate yourself. Ah, what do I get? There is nothing to live on. I've been here for years, nothing to show. But I'm telling you, God. God who visited Sarah when the enemy were about to mock her. The same God of the 11:59 minutes ago. The last minute God who visited Anna. Even though she was mocked and called a barren woman. When the time came that the people were about to mock her. God said, no, this is my case. Relax. I love this part.
Oh, yes.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
At the deadliest part of your life, don't run from God.
Amen.
Go close to God and say, Lord, I know you allowed it for a purpose.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
You may be here for long. Ah, I have no document. People who came here, they have a document. I want to leave. I want to go somewhere. Shut up. Shut up. Do you want to say God is not aware?
God is aware.
Where is that God who took you from where you were? Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
David said, God took me in Psalm 40 verses 2. He took me out of the miry clay. Out of the horrible pit of he took me. And he placed my foot upon the rock. Hallelujah. So if God took you from where you were, that you were ridiculed, you were a borrower, a fornicator, a killer, a murderer, useless, nothing good was good about you, but God took you and decided to establish you. Why will you say God has forgotten you? Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Sometimes the silence of God is not like I will not say God abandons his children.
At all, never.
Sometimes he keeps silent to see whether we are mature.
Oh, yes.
Why Job was being tempted? God was there.
Yes, sir. He was aware.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
God was even the one that orchestrated the meeting.
Mm-hmm.
He even called the devil. Have you seen my servant Job? Have you seen? God was proud. While Job was busy living his normal life on earth, in the heavens there were discussion over him. So also be faithful to God every day of your life.
Amen.
You don't know whether God is trying you.
Tell us.
Ah, I don't get documents. I don't tire. God, I got God, I beg it. God knows. When your time comes, nothing will stop you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
If it is time for the money to be done, do you force the money to be done? The sun arises with power. Why? It is the time for the sun to come out.
Yes.
You don't struggle. You don't have to work it out and make some manipulations so that the sun will shine. No. Amen.
Amen.
When the time comes, hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
I said, when your time comes, no man will hinder you.
Amen.
When your time comes, your light will shine.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lastly, let us take. Okay. Romans 11, verses 1. Maybe I'll do continuation next week. Hallelujah. Because of dedication, so that we don't take much time.
Romans chapter 11, verses 1. I read in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I said then, had God cast away his people?
Mm-mm.
God forbid.
God forbid.
For I also am an Israelite mm-hmm. of the seed of Abraham, of the tribe of Benjamin.
Uh-huh.
God hath not cast away his people.
At all.
Which he foreknew. Would ye not what the scripture said of Elijah.
Uh-huh.
How he maketh intercession to God against Israel, saying, Lord, they have killed thy prophet and dig down thy altar, and I am left alone, and they seek my life. But what saith the answer of God unto him? I have preserved to myself 7,000 men
uh-huh.
who have not bowed their knee to the image of Baal.
Mm-hmm.
Even so then,
at this present time
also, there is a
remnant according to the election of grace. There is a remnant according to election of grace. There is a generation according to election of grace. There is a people in God's family, God's kingdom family, according to the election of grace. The grace elected you and selected you for purpose.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
The Bible says, Elijah was crying that he was the only prophet remaining, that Jezebel had killed all God's prophets. But God's response was, I have 7,000 men that has not even bowed down. Why? I choose those people by grace for myself. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Read on verse 6.
Verse 6. And if by grace, then is it no more of work? Otherwise, grace is no more grace. But if it be of work, then is it no more grace? Otherwise, work is no more work. What then?
Okay, read verses 13, please.
Verses 13, I read in Jesus' name.
Amen.
For I seek to you, Gentiles, inasmuch as I am the apostle of Gentiles,
I magnify my office. Uh-huh.
If by any means I may provoke to emulation them which are my flesh, I might save some of them. For if the casting away of them be the reconciling of the world,
mm-hmm.
what shall the receiving of them be? But life from the dead. For if the first fruit be holy, the lumps is also holy.
Uh-huh.
And if the root be holy,
the so branches are also the branches. Holy.
And if some of the branches be broken off, and thou be a white olive tree.
Listen. If some of the branches be broken off, and you being a white olive tree, we are grafted in among them, and with them partaketh of the roots and fatness of the olive tree. Boast not yourself against the branches, but if thou boast, thou beareth not the roots, but the root thee. Hallelujah. Do you get this message here? In verse 17. I'm talking about saved by grace. Now, if you and I, who we are Gentile by nature, we are not Israelite by nature or by birth. Is it truth?
Yes, sir.
We are Gentiles. But our faith has qualified us. Look at what the Bible says. If those who we are Gentiles by nature, we are qualified, we are enabled, we are allowed to come in. Are you following?
Yes, sir.
Now, if these people are allowed to come in and partake, and they were not originally the Israelite by birth, but by faith. Praise Jesus. That's to say, you were not qualified to be here this morning, but grace decided to qualify you in. You were not qualified to enjoy the finished work of the cross of Jesus. Are you following?
Yes, sir.
You were not qualified. Why? You are not an Israelite by nature. But by faith, you have been grafted in. By faith, listen, have you seen a branch of tree? A tree. Okay, let me give you a raw example. You see olive tree. You remove the branch. You take another type of tree and fix the branch into it and tie it. And he's now enjoying blessings from the olive tree. If the branch is not originally olive, maybe it's a mango branch, but has been wet into it, it's now enjoying the blessings of the olive oil. So I will. Hallelujah. So originally, we were not part of it. But by our faith in Christ Jesus, we have been grafted in. Amen. To enjoy that blessings. And that is why we are alive.
Oh, yes.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
I pray as we hear this word that God Almighty will bless us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let's be on our feet. Are we blessed this morning?
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
If you are blessed, let me see your hands.
I am blessed.
Amen. You and I, we are not qualified. We were not qualified. But His grace qualified us. The finished work on the cross took us in. When the curtain, the veil that was hindering us, and Jesus said, "It is finished." And therefore the veil was torn. And we now have access to come in by faith. So by our faith, we are qualified, the Israelites. By our faith in Christ Jesus, we are saved. Praise Jesus. Do not boast yourself. It is a work of grace. Say, "My Father, my Father. Your grace in my life.
Your grace in my life.
I will not abuse.
I will not abuse.
I will not abuse your grace.
I will not abuse
your grace. I will not abuse your work.
I will not abuse
open your mouth and turn it to prayer.
My Father, my maker.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
Jehovah, your grace.
Your grace.
I will not abuse, oh Lord.
We will not abuse.
I will not abuse, oh Lord.
We will not abuse your grace, Jesus.
I will not frustrate your grace in my life.
We will not abuse your grace.
In the name of Jesus, thank you for your saving.
Help us to align ourselves in your world.
Thank you for your
grace. Help us to walk according to the election of grace.
That has made me who
I am. We are Gentiles by nature. And we are grafted in by faith in Christ Jesus. And today we are called the sons of the kingdom. Today we are called the sons of God. Because of our faith. Because of our faith on the finished work of the cross.
Papa, King of glory,
and we are not qualified sons of kingdom,
help me, oh Lord, not to
sons and daughters of the kingdom.
Help me not to
Lord, may I not abuse this grace.
In the name of Jesus,
help me, Lord,
you have given unto me.
Don't allow me to abuse this grace.
Father, help me.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Your grace. Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
When grace is absent from your life, it becomes race and struggle. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Say, "My Father, my Father.
My Father, my Father.
Let your grace not be absent in my life.
Let your grace not be absent in my life.
Otherwise.
Otherwise.
I cannot make it.
I cannot make
open
it.
Open your mouth and begin to pray.
My Father, my Maker has I
open your mouth and pray.
Let your grace never depart.
Turn it to prayer.
Let your grace never
let your grace not depart from my life.
Let your grace, oh Lord.
Otherwise.
Grace, oh Lord,
I cannot make it, Lord.
From my life, oh Lord.
If otherwise, I cannot make it.
If not,
help me, Jesus.
Oh Lord, I cannot run this.
Help me, Jesus.
Oh Lord, Father King.
Help me, Jesus.
Let your grace, oh Lord,
help me, Jesus.
In every situation and circumstance, let your grace, oh Lord, stand for me, oh Lord.
Let your grace speak for me.
Depart from me.
Let your grace speak for me. Let your grace speak for me.
In the time of
trouble, let your grace speak for me.
Father, let your grace, oh Lord, speak.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Jesus Christ.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
I want us to pray lastly. I don't know all you have been asking God for. We're going to plead the grace of God in it. That because of the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, I will receive my testimonies. Amen. Because of the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, I will receive my documents. Amen. Because of the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, I will receive the right partner.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because of the grace of God upon my life, I will carry my own child. Because of the grace of God upon my life, I will carry my own testimony.
Amen.
Open your mouth and begin to speak to your life. Whatever you want, plead the grace of God. However you want it. Oh God, let your grace make way for us many who are believing you now, Lord.
I shall possess
grace
because of your grace upon my life, oh Lord. I am brought,
oh Lord, in your highest dimension, oh Lord.
Lord, may your grace open doors.
Have a father
that root that has been shut for many years. In the name of Jesus, I say be open. That document the enemy took from you. In the name of Jesus, be restored. That happiness the enemy stole from you. In the name of Jesus, be restored. May the grace of God speak for you. Wherever they summon your name, in any occultic kingdom, may the grace of God speak for you. In a faith perfect place, in any water, wherever they mention your name, may the grace of God speak for you. Say, oh God, may your grace speak for me. In the day, in the night, everywhere I go, let your grace speak for me.
Wherever my children go, wherever
where may I expect go, me to fall? Let your grace speak for me. I will not fall.
In the name of Jesus.
I will not fall.
Let your grace speak for me. In the name of
your grace
Jesus.
To accept.
Your grace to accept.
Your grace of my testimony.
In the name of Jesus. Because of your grace that is upon my life, I will not fail and I will not fall.
In the name of Jesus.
May your grace speak for me, Lord.
Let your grace speak for me.
I will not fail. I will not fall. Wherever the enemies are expecting me to fall, let your grace speak for me. Every evil expectation against my life, against my marriage, against my children, against my sources, against my testimony, let your grace speak for me. Let your grace speak for me. Let your grace speak for me. Let your grace speak for me.
Let your grace speak for me.
It is your grace that makes a difference.
Your grace,
O
Lord, speak for me. In the name of Jesus.
Thank you. Your grace qualifies me for favor and not labor. Let your grace speak for me. Let your grace speak for me. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Take your seat with you.